Today I'm with Birkett from Carbon Light. We're going to talk about good practice for weather-resistant barriers and common practice for weather-resistant barriers. Birkett, we've got a common sort of installation of sarking here. What are the issues with this?
Well, here we've got a scenario which could be built to common 6-star rating, if you like. So you've got a non-diffusion open blue sarking in this scenario. The main aim is to keep the weather out and make it wind resistant and weather resistant.
Yeah.
But as you can see here, most of the joints are not sealed.
Yeah.
Then you've got the joints around the window, the gaps around the windows are not sealed.
Yep.
If they're sealed, sometimes you see them sealed really poorly with duct tape.
Yeah.
Last about a couple of weeks and it'll come off. It'll just last long enough for the cladding to go on. It's not a solution that will last for decades.
Yeah. So that's with the junctions around windows, but also with how they're overlapping potentially as well, or if penetrations go through, you know, nothing is really continuous.
No, there is no, you can see some of the gaps around the windows here are open.
Yeah.
So it's just not even, we're not even talking about high performance, it's just simple rain actually getting into the structure. So you won't just have your massively reduced thermal performance of the house, you will also actually have water getting in and resulting in structural damage and rot and mold and whatnot.
All right, then let's move over now to good practice. Okay, Birkett, so this is now good practice with a membrane. Show us how this differs from what we just saw.
Yeah. So if you imagine this wall is perfectly sealed, weathertight, wind resistant, with the membrane continuing through.
Yep.
Now, if we start cutting a hole into it, we would have to recreate that connection to our window.
Yep.
In the conventional construction, you can saw that on the other side, it's just cut flush with the stud frame opening. So there's no tape, there's no steel connection, there's no watertight connection. So water has got unrestricted access to the building. Mm-hmm. Now in this scenario here, we're creating on the bottom, we're creating a seal flushing before installing the window. Then the window frame is prepared with a double-sided tape. Okay, so the tape is on the window first, simple installation, and then we're folding it and taping it onto the membrane. Now we've got a completely sealed, weathertight and diffusion open connection to the window, and we can rely on this membrane to keep the weather out before flooding goes on.
So for this weather resistive barrier, let's hit it with a hose and see how both sides perform. So Birkett, we're simulating 30 kilometer hour winds on this enclosure right now, which is blow it all testing. Let's hit it with some water and see how much of it goes inside.
Yep, we've got two settings. I'm just gonna do a light rain, so on mist, and then we're moving on to heavier, a bit more pressure.
Yep.
Real life scenario, you know, we don't want to.
You can clearly feel airflow around this window, especially on the sides too, right?
Yeah, and it's 30 k's an hour wind, you know, it's not anything outrageous we're talking about.
And if this water gets in, all our insulation under the window is going to get saturated.
Well, and it's not just the insulation, that is the most concerning part are the structural components in there. So if the structural components start being wet inside the wall, then you've got a non-diffusion open membrane.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, you're closing that moisture into the wall structure, and that really results in structural damage. You know, that is a real concern.
Yep.
So this is now the shower function, so a bit heavier rain, right?
Yep.
That's heavy rain, right? But we're trying to showcase the point here.
Okay, let's check out the other side with the good practice, yeah?
Let's do it.
Okay, Birkett, now without hosing me down, let's see what this one does.
All right, we've just got this on mist, all right?
Yeah.
So we're just trying to we're going to do a couple of runs, one in like light mist and then a bit of heavier rain.
Yep.
Okay. So we're just trying to get a realistic scenario of sort of decent rain, and we can also set this at a higher.
I mean, you can see that the water's just not going anywhere, right?
No, it's just running off. I mean, it is just doing what it's supposed to do. This thing is just completely sealed.
Yeah.
There is no problems at all. And this is not just water, this is also wind, obviously, as well.
All right, so now let's go and have a look inside.
All right, let's go.
Using amazing building materials is only part of the story. The most important part of constructing a building is making the important connections for airtightness and weatherproofing. If you think this footage doesn't show common practice well enough, you should take a drive around any major construction site in Australia. You'll find many examples of exactly the same level of workmanship. When we talk about building for a better seal, we're not talking about sealing up houses so that people can't breathe. We're talking about keeping our homes dry from rain and from rotting from the inside and the outside. We want to protect the occupants by providing good ventilation and proper sealing. Build tight and ventilate right. The future of residential building in Australia will be strongly influenced by consumer demand for energy efficiency, comfort, climate resilience, and quality. Both the Building Codes Board and Australian governments are committed to the COAG trajectory for low energy buildings, and this will affect building regulations, including the NCC. Builders will be expected to place increased emphasis on meeting and proving energy efficiency compliance. You'll be asked more and more to understand and deliver both code compliance and long-term building health and performance. You will need to build tight and ventilate right.